Well, he's the biggest moneymaker for theaters the past 2 years. Will he make his next movie in Wisconsin?
The ink is not dry, but the governor's office says the state is about to close a deal that would bring Johnny Depp to Wisconsin to play John Dillinger. 12 News' Mike Anderson has the story.
Johnny Depp may be best known for playing Captain Jack Sparrow in the Pirates of the Caribbean.
I'm good with it. Shall we seal it in blood? I mean, ink.
But the governor's office says he may likely follow actor Mark Harmon, who played John Dillinger in a TV movie made in Wisconsin about John Dillinger 17 years ago.
Here in Racine, the John Dillinger story is not a movie. It is a real-life drama played out November 20th, 1933.
This is a bullet from the Dillinger gang. It was recovered from the bank and trust during the armed robbery of that day.
It looks much different today, more than 70 years later at 5th and Main in downtown Racine. An art museum stands in place of the American bank and trust Dillinger robbed. According to the criminal complaint of that day, Dillinger was public enemy number one. He not only hit the Racine Bank for $27,000, he also took hostages and stole a police officer's machine gun. This one right here, the department has preserved all these years.
Sergeant Hansen from the Racine Police Department came into the bank with this weapon. He was shot by one of the Dillinger gang, fell to the ground and dropped the weapon. The weapon was then grabbed by one of the gang members, shot out the front windows, and then they continued on outside.
The weapon was later recovered, but not before Dillinger signed it as if it was his own. 7 months later, FBI agents shot him to death in Chicago. Can you see Johnny Depp as John Dillinger? Sources tell 12 News it's a 99% safe bet that he'll be shooting in Wisconsin this year. Mike Anderson, WISN 12 News.
Lieutenant Governor's office said today they expect the deal to be finalized shortly. It would be the first major production to come to Wisconsin since new tax incentives for the film industry took effect January 1st.